mess. It's a mess of money what crews had to use to clean up millions of dollars in coins spilled all over the highway.
Let's rock and roll. We are talking about Cleveland music legend Alan Freed with his son Lance live in our studio this morning. We'll talk to him in just a few minutes. Right now, I want to check in with Kenny Crumpton. Good morning, Kenny.
Good morning. I didn't get hit. Let me make sure there's none around. Last time I said something, I got hit. Okay. Brandon River Roller Girls are right here. Their season has started. Big bout tomorrow here at the Wolstein Center. When we come back, we're going to show you some more cool roller derby stuff. Kicking it with Kenny. Stay with us.
All right, let's check in with Kenny Crumpton, who is hanging out with the Roller Girls this morning.
He's in heaven.
Yes, he is. There's no doubt about it. Hey, Kenny, good morning.
Whatever, make up your mind.
Hey.
Hey.
Happy Friday to you. Okay. All right, we're here at the Wolstein. So, excuse me, Sparkle. There's a baby in there, Kenny. Watch yourself. Oh, we're here at the Wolstein Center hanging out with the Running Rainbow Roller Girls. Been out since 2006, and we're very, very proud of them here in Cleveland because they've done really well. They've expanded. So, Sparkle, let's talk about what we're seeing here. This isn't a pose for a painting you guys are going to take, like, later on, you know, for the cover of Burning River Roller Girls. All right, so actually getting ready to do something here.
Yes. One of the newer trends in derby right now is called a scrum start, which is what we have set up here. And it's a strategic thing. Basically, if all of one team is on a knee, there's no pack. And so if there's no pack, the jammer whistle starts right away. They don't have to wait until everyone crosses that line. It's a way to maximize time on the clock, you know, get the jam started right away.
Interesting.
So we can go ahead and do this. Basically, it would start off like this.
They're on their knees.
One jammer will blow the whistle.
And then they go.
And so they're right there, ready to block that jammer immediately.
Wow.
It's also a kind of a psychological thing. Jammers aren't used to having the pack directly
right
in front
there.
Of them.
Yeah,
it gets in your head.
Now, she's lead jammer now.
So she's lead. And,
can the second jammer, can they try to block the lead jammer?
They can.
Okay, so
they can catch her, can block her.
So they're not out of it.
No.
Okay.
And
okay.
Actually, one thing that a jammer, if they're this close, one thing that black jammer should do is try as hard as she can to get up in front of that jammer and force her to call it off before either of them score points.
Wow. So she can,
she's not out of it.
Yeah, so there's a lot of strategic things she can do. Let's do another one again so people can see that, and then we have the time.
All right. So another one that can happen is sometimes everyone gets lined up, but one team forgets to drop to their knee. Team forgets. Oopsies. And so everyone's standing. And then that first whistle blows. Well, now the jammers can't go until anyone drops that. So three people will drop down. One person skates out to create the no pack.
Gotcha. That's pretty cool. Now, tell everybody when we can come see you guys tomorrow.
It's tomorrow night here at the Wolstein Center. Doors open at 5. Game starts at 6. And it's fun guaranteed for all.
Season is underway. And how many bouts do you guys have this season, ballpark?
We have 5 bouts per season. We had our first one earlier in March, and our second one is tomorrow night.
Okay.
They're usually about once a month.
Okay, very good. And congratulations with you.
Thank
and
you.
If they want more information, they can go to your website, which is?
www.burningriverrollergirls.com.
Thank you so much, Sparkle. Thank you, ladies. All right, we're going to go back to you guys in the studio. Look at these hot women. I love it.
No, and they're tough, and I like that about them, too.
Yes. Kenny, thanks.